Well, not everything went the way of the coalition last night. Its biggest loss was the defeat of former Prime Minister Tony Abbott. Brett, he had a margin of 11%, but defeats really don't get bigger than when you get smashed by an independent.
They really don't, and this perhaps was the most closely watched race in the nation, and it seems Mr. Abbott may have only had himself to blame. Julie Bishop, his one-time deputy leader, said he was rejected by his electorate because of his stance on issues like climate change and same-sex marriage. It's a humiliating end to a 25-year parliamentary career. But his loss is also being seen by some here in Canberra as giving clear air to Prime Minister Scott Morrison.
Tony Abbott arrived at his election party last night as a former Prime Minister who lost his long-held seat in a landslide.
Tonight, we've got good news, and yes, we've got a little bit of bad news.
This morning, the fitness-loving politician was getting back on his bike in the electorate he held for a quarter of a century.
Just nothing to add to what I said last night.
He repeatedly referred to this election as the fight of his political life.
I'd rather be a loser than a quitter.
Tony Abbott has held many titles: minister, opposition leader, prime minister, a Rhodes Scholar who briefly trained as a priest, and a former amateur boxer who didn't budge on his conservative and often controversial convictions.
A climate change denier personified and clearly out of step with his electorate.
He served as Australia's 28th Prime Minister for just shy of 2 years, and after being toppled by Malcolm Turnbull, promised this.
There'll be no wrecking, no undermining, and no sniping.
But agitate he did from the backbenches.
Even during this election campaign, Tony Abbott couldn't promise that he wasn't going to challenge as leader again. I guess we've sorted that problem out tonight.
I might be accused by true believers of being too sentimental, but I'm a bit sad to see a former Prime Minister go out like that.
Another former Prime Minister who knows the pain of losing his seat is Mr. Abbott's longtime boss.
I grieve for his loss and I salute the enormous contribution that Tony has made to public life in Australia.
Other former colleagues lashing out at what Mr. Abbott called an ugly campaign waged against him.
Whilst you're going after him, you forgot about the other seats. You might have won, you clowns.
There is now talk among the Liberal Party that Tony Abbott will be offered a posting overseas.
And so, after 25 years, a new era has begun in the once blue ribbon seat of Warringah, with Zali Steggall, a barrister and one-time Olympic skier, causing one of the biggest upsets of the election.
He has done a long service to this community in many ways, and I think that has to be rewarded and recognised, and we are all thankful. It's just a moment to move on.
So look in here for me, nice big smile, excellent.
The independent, now the poster girl, in a seat vacated by a man who undoubtedly had a big impact on the course of a nation. Helen Isbister, SBS World News.